Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your agriculture update, and this is for the weekend of October 26th, Friday, 2018. So if you look behind me, it's an unusual day because we have a green section and we've got our red section, which is a little bit interesting. Gold and silver up. The stock market, as you know, got hit pretty hard. Dollar index gave up a little bit, and as it fell back, we got some bids into the grain markets, which I found interesting. Now, I want you to also remember, I'll fix my jacket here so I look perfect for you, that on the weekend edition, we take a look first at one monthly chart, and then everything else after that's going to be the weekly charts, because I think it's good on a weekend that you take a look at the markets from a bit of a larger perspective. So when we first take a look at the monthly area chart of closes on the beans, we can see we've gone from 1045, that was the high this year, back down and on a closing basis, that is, to a low of 833, and off those lows, you're 12 cents so far. So it's not as though we've had a big rally. For the month, the market is what though? It's down a half a cent. In other words, we've gone nowhere. When we take a look at a weekly bar chart, I just want to show you, you went from 810.5 to 906, back to, so far, 811.5, 892, and you've been breaking, and for the week, we're down 11.75 cents. When we look at a weekly chart with the swing line study, you have a pattern of a lower low and a higher high, not a trend, but if you don't take out this 811.5, what happens on this, if you don't do that, you're probably going to end up with a pattern of higher lows, higher highs. The first sign the market might be getting bullish. The key is not to take out that 811.5. The battleground for the market is what I teach, called the line in the sand, the 18-week moving average of closes. That number is 852.25. You finished at 845 for the week. So you got up here to 892. You've pulled down. You closed under it, but not by very much. Again, I'm going to say the market's not trending, but I will say because you're under that 18-week average of closes that the resistance is 852.25. When markets get under it, the first challenge back to it is often a resistance point. In Bollinger Bands, you have not hit an upper Bollinger Band or a lower Bollinger Band since back in July. Now, the importance of that is Bollinger Bands offer a resistance point and a support point 95% of the time. Whether you're looking at a weekly chart, monthly, or daily, the market will trade within these bands 95% of the time and only 5% of the time out of it. So we're not in an extreme. What else do you notice on the bands? They're trying to flatten out right here. So we're starting to develop a market that doesn't have the volatility it had when it was dropping like this. It's more or less trying to go sideways. Hasn't completed that yet, but that's what it's trying to do. In terms of momentum, the momentum's fairly flat right here. In other words, it's trying to come back, but it isn't pointing down. It's just sort of flat here, the bias down and without a trend. When we come to the meal market, we have a higher high, lower low pattern, bias down, momentum flat. That's all that you can say about it there. This market made a run for the 100-week average of closes and didn't do anything. It got up towards it and pulled back instead. Soybean oil, you have the pattern of a higher high, lower low. Battleground seems to be right now, if you look at that, the 18-week moving average of closes. I'll call the bias down and I'll call momentum flat right here. By the way, the difference here is you got up to that upper Bollinger Band, what I explained before, the resistance point, and you got thrown back after hitting it. What else? You've got this sideways action developing. I think that's important. In the corn market, this market is actually bullish. You have a pattern of higher lows. You have the higher highs. You made your first real run up to the 378, the upper Bollinger Band. You fell back. You found support at the 100-week average. There could be further support if you drop down into the 18-week average. But this market is friendly. And momentum, well, it's flattened out a bit right here. And I would expect that with the pullback, but it's not pointing down. In the wheat market, it's a different story. This market's bearish. You have lower highs, lower lows. Momentum is still pointing down. See the reds under the blue, still not a deep push, but it's there. And if the market rallies, I'd look for resistance back at the 516 level on this chart. The 18-week average of close is about 11 cents higher. In the cocoa market, you had, the word is past tense, lower highs, lower lows, bearish, and you were under the 18-week average of closes. But what has happened here is after we had this break, the market started rallying, and suddenly it's playing between the 100-week average and the 18. Two things developed. First, close back over the 18-week average. That's friendly. That gives the market an upside bias, and momentum is turned up. So while the swing line is down, two of the other forces are pointing favorable. A market that is ahead of itself, as far as I'm concerned, is the sugar. You now have 3 weeks in a row where the market's closed over the upper Bollinger Band. Coming into this week, I give it a 2% chance of staying over that. However, that's not bearish. All that means is a market that's been very strong is starting to run up into an area where it's likely to start faltering, especially as it approaches the 100-week average. But as I said, there's nothing bearish on this. Pullbacks are very different from predicting a market top. In the coffee market, talking about what I was just saying in the sugar, this is how a market, if you look back here, made its run, got over the upper Bollinger Band, then that 100-week average came into play at the green line, and as you can see, the market now is pulling back under both the Bollinger Band and that. So there's a difference between being bearish and not having that upside bias, and that's what I'm saying there. Watch cotton right here. Cotton's starting to put in what could be an important area. Now, this week's low was 76.14, which did take out 76.15. But notice how the market's unable to reach for the lower Bollinger Band anymore. The battleground's become the 100-week average. What you need is momentum to pick up next week and start pointing higher, and that could get friendly, this chart. As it is right now, I'm going to look at the chart as having a lower low, a higher high. There's no trend there. The bias down and momentum is still bearish. In the cattle market, friendly. You've got higher lows, higher highs, which gives the trend up. The momentum is up because you're over the 18-week average, and along with everything else, the bias. So this market is still bullish. Target zone, the 116 area, the 100-week average and upper Bollinger Band is a resistance point. When I come to the hog market, you have a pattern of an outside week up. So you got higher lows, higher highs. The momentum of the market is down because you're under the 18-week average, but the bias is up as you're looking at this. So I'm looking at a market that's fairly friendly there. Now, one of the things you might want to look at when you're an ag trader is what goes on a seasonal basis. And the company that I know that I think does a great job of it is More Research. Now, they'll give you the monthly trades. Then they give you what the cash looks like as well. You can look at the special reports. You can go back in time. And they have their studies. Give you an example. In order to hit 100% reliability, it's got to go 15 years in a row doing something. Then they break it down. What if you're right 14 out of 15 or 13 out of 15? If a trade doesn't fit into that category that it hasn't done it, it's not included in the study. You're going to find there's a lot of agriculture trades that do that. So ag are one of the products I like because you're dealing with seasonality, you're dealing with what the crops do, not only in America, what they do in other parts of the world. And what they do is they allow you to look at bull and bear years. So you can go in and the report will look like this. You can click on it. And then you get to play with their charts. And you can go back and see bull years, bear years, then the special reports they put out. I've been using this service for what I know, probably, 25 years or so. And as you can see, this is what those graphs would look like. And yes, you can remove neutral years and the other and start playing with it to get an idea of what you want. We're able to give you a 2-week free trial. All you need to do is go to our website at www.irapstein.com, sign up for it. You'll see the more research. You see our phone number here. You can also call my staff, or you can click up here to get to that page. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great weekend, and I'll see you Monday.